بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. The point of benefit for tonight is still about dua, about supplications, and it relates to the transgression in dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-A'raf, chapter 7, verse 55, ادعوا ربكم تضرعا وخفيا إنه لا يحب المعتدين. ادعوا ربكم تضرعا وخفيا إنه لا يحب المعتدين. سورة الأعراف chapter 7 verse 55. And invoke your Lord Allah with humility and in secret. He likes not the aggressors. And the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said in the hadith, سيكون قوم يعتدون في الدعاء. There will be people who will transgress in their invocations. And some of the forms of transgression include requesting that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade and prohibited for his slaves in this life, as in the case when the companions of Musa alayhi salam asked him to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or for someone to seek children without getting married. This is one form of transgression in dua. And the second form is excessiveness in requesting details in the form of the dua. Like, for example, someone may say, an example on this is, اللهم إني أسألك القصر الأبيض عن يمين الجنة إذ دخلتها. O Allah, I ask you the white palace to the right of paradise when I will enter it. This is a transgression in dua in details. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the paradise, to enter paradise. And from that is raising one's voice, being loud in dua. From the benefits of keeping the dua secret, as illustrated by Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, is number one, it is stronger in asserting faith, because the person knows that Allah hears the invocation, the secret one, and this is more profound when it comes to sincerity and tranquility and submissiveness. And secondly, its effect is greater in terms of manners and magnification, in terms of manners and magnification, because here in this life with the kings, you don't raise your voice in front of them. Anyone who does this, they will hate. And to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belongs the best example. Also, the third point is that it is an indication of the nearness and closeness of the person to the most near, Allah, the most high. Contemplate, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised his slave Zakariya, Prophet Zakariya, بقوله, when he mentioned about him in Surah Maryam, chapter 19, verse 3, إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ نِدَاءً خَفِيًّا إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ نِدَاءً خَفِيًّا. من سورة مريم verse 3, when he called out his Lord Allah, a call in secret. So when he contemplated that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is closer to him than anything that is close, he kept his call in secret to the best of his ability. This ends the point of benefit on the matter of transgression in dua. Walhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.